Gelatin Zymography. Zymography is a simple, sensitive, quantifiable, and functional assay for the analysis of enzyme activity in tissue or in polyacrylamide gel. There are many variations of the technique. We will demonstrate here gelatinase activity assay by SDS-PAGE, taking conditioned medium from animal cell culture as source of gelatinase activity. Principle. In conditioned media of mammalian cells contain matrix metalloproteinases, MMP2 and MMP9. They are released from cells in a proteolytically inactive proform called a zymogen. Because the inactive form becomes activated during the process of denaturation and renaturation after gel electrophoresis, the active form of the enzyme degrades the substrate gelatin. After the electrophoretic run, the SDS is soaked out from the gel, that is zymogram, by incubation in tritone X100, a detergent followed by incubation in an appropriate buffer for an optimized length of time and temperature. The gelatin hydrolyzed zones are seen as white bands against blue background of the gel when it is stained with Comasi brilliant blue. Procedure. Assemble the glass plate on a clean surface. Lay the longer glass plate down first and then place a shorter glass plate on top of it. Embed them into the casting frame and clamp them properly. Make sure that the bottom ends of the glass plates are properly aligned. Place a casting frame onto the casting stand. Pour some distilled water between the arranged glass plates to check the leaking between the plates. Remove the water by placing a blotting paper in between the glass plate as shown. Place a comb in between the glass plates and make a mark 1 cm below the comb teeth. Take a blue capped tube and label it as a resolving gel. Preparation of 10% resolving gel. The reagents used are 5 ml of gelatin solution made in 1.5 molar tris of pH 8.8, 30% acrylamide bisacrylamide mixture of 3.5 ml, 82.5 microliter of 10% SDS, 82.5 microliters of 50% glycerol, ammonium persulfate or APS of 100 microliter, and 0.010 ml or 10 microliter of Temet, which should be kept in an ice box. Once the Temet is added to the mix, immediately pour the resolving gel into the glass plate up to the mark drawn. Pour 1 ml of water saturated butanol above the resolving gel layer. Allow the gel to polymerize for 20 to 30 minutes. During this time, prepare the stacking gel. The composition of 5% stacking gel, 3.4 ml of distilled water, 0.83 ml of 30% acrylamide bisacrylamide mix, 0.63 ml of 1 molar tris of pH 6.8, 0.05 ml of 10% SDS. Add these reagents into a blue capped tube labeled stacking gel. After the gel has polymerized, water-saturated N-butanol layer was absorbed by placing a blotting paper in between the glass plates. Now add 0.05 ml of APS and 0.005 ml of Temet from the icebox to the blue capped tube. Immediately pour the stacking gel in between the glass plates till it overflows. Now place a comb in the stacking gel sandwich and allow the gel to polymerize for 10 minutes. Meanwhile, prepare the samples for loading into the wells of the gel. Mix the protein samples with 4x gel loading dye in the ratio of 4:1. To run the gel, take out the apparatus from the casting frame and clamp it onto the gel apparatus. Make sure the short plate always faces inside, and if you have only one plate to run, keep a dummy plate for balance. Keep the plates in the cassette and then lock it. Now place this cassette in the tank. Fill the inner chamber of the tank with 1x running buffer of pH 8.3. Now remove the comb carefully without breaking the wells. Rinse the wells with 1x running buffer using syringe. Rinse the loading tip with buffer. Samples can now be loaded onto the gel. Deliver the 20 microliters of the protein sample into the well, carefully by inserting the tip to a few millimeters from the well bottom without breaking the wells. Rinse the loading tip with the buffer after each loading. Close the lid of the gel tank and connect the wires to electrical circuit. Make sure the connection is proper, that is black lead to black and red lead to red. Now set the voltage at 150 volt and run for about 1 hour or until the diaphragm runs to the end of the gel. Now switch off the power supply and disconnect the electrical leads. Take out the gel plates and remove the gel from the plates into a box. Wash the gel with distilled water. Pour Tritone X100 into the box containing gel and keep it for 5 minutes in the orbit shaker. Repeat this step thrice. Discard the Tritone X100 solution and add low salt collagenase buffer into the gel and leave overnight on an orbit shaker or minimum for 4 to 6 hours. After overnight incubation, discard the low salt collagenase buffer and pour staining solution into the gel. Keep it for 30-minute incubation in orbit shaker. Destain the gel until the bands are properly seen. The presence of gelatinolytic activity of protein samples loaded will be seen as clear bands against a blue background.